Emergency stalking mascara, Marty. Hey, it's Susan. Welcome to this morning's episode of War Crimes. Hey, nice to see ya. Boy, I'm serious on this. I'm serious on this, everybody. Emergency stalking unique mascara party. You know, if you want to get the 3D fiber lashes, you know, and get the eyes that everybody's talking about, or any other product from Unique, it will help me earn very, very quick money to keep the bad guys away, because Unique pays me within hours of you making your online purchase. So very appreciated. Go to my Facebook page, Make Yourself Unique, YOUNIQUE, or my other Facebook pages on the catwalk. On the catwalk or the iSue's home shopping mall to find the party link. Okay, whoa, boy, here we go. Here we go again. The stalking sex predator at another McDonald's. I mean, you know, it was bound to happen. They sabotaged my nursing employment. That has been sabotaged. That was my primary source of income. I make a lot of money as a nurse. You know, and so I cannot work as a nurse until my employment, or until that gets unsabotaged. Okay, so then we had the stalking sex predator come out at McDonald's last night. And, you know, it's following the same pattern that happens in every other city and state that I go to. And you know, it's like the same arm ring in the back end, different puppet players in the front end. Well, I was able to get away from him. And then I tried to go to the El Paso Police Department to make a report on him. And they would not take a report. Okay, red flag. Anytime a police department does not take a report, that usually means that they're behind this. Pay attention. My case is really, really big. This says U.S. Marshal Service. Most everyday people don't know the Marshals, right? Okay, this is Homeland Security. Most everyday people don't know Homeland Security. This is an MP. Okay, so I got bad guys off the damn wazoo. I mean, highly sophisticated criminals. And so I cannot take any chances. And when a police department won't make the report, usually that means I've got the bait issue going on in the back end. You know, people using me as bait for these jackasses and so forth. So when the police wouldn't take a report, that concerned me. Then I asked them if they would take a report on my family, my extended family that's missing throughout the state of Texas. See, I know police departments can do that, and I haven't been able to get any police department in Texas to do that. They refuse to take a report on that, too. So, see, like, when the police, I know, are not taking reports, that means I got to get the hell out of damn town. See, and I already know that the sheriff's office doesn't patrol within the city of El Paso. I learned that from a investigator within the sheriff's department, so that's hella bad. But I was able to get away. Border Patrol helped steer me in the right direction, so I wasn't going to get, you know, knocked around on the highway and stuff. God, I love Border Patrol. Thank God there's Border Patrol. They're my backbone. And so I was able to get away from that, but I am not totally out of danger. I am miles away from the latest incident, but that doesn't mean that the bad guys won't catch up with me. And right now, I really need to be getting the hell out of the city that I'm in and probably into another country. But anyway, that's this morning's episode of War Crimes Unit Emergency Mascara Party. Find it at On the Catwalk, Make Yourself Unique, or at the iSue's Home Shopping Mall on Facebook, and your purchase is very appreciated. Today's episode, keep your stun gun or machine gun handy, or automatic weapon handy. There's real criminals and terrorists out there. Not me.